Accent on speed. More and more high-speed jet aircraft are coming into service with the Royal Air Force. But the accent must be on speed with safety. The cockpit of this Meteor 8 jet fighter is fitted with the Martin Baker ejection seat. The ejection seat is a real lifesaver. But this sign means what it says. Danger. Extreme danger to those who don't understand it. Listen.
Morning, George. Morning, Fred. Seems funny somehow seeing all these jets about lately, George.
Yes, wonderful jobs. I saw one of those new javelins touch down on the airstrip near the main road yesterday. Terrific.
Faster than sound, eh? Well, I wouldn't swap with him. At that speed, what chances have you got if anything goes wrong?
I thought of that, too. Don't you worry.
Telegram Tower, door 4-2. Request emergency landing.
Roger, 4-2. We'll clear circuit.
Don't think I can make it. Short of gravy.
I'll come straight in on runway 2-2.
Roger.
Crash
action. Stand by.
Will you come up, sir? Emergency landing.
Sir, coming
straight in, short of
fuel. Hello, 4-2. Winko here. Can you make the runway?
I'll try, but I'll probably undershoot.
If it looks too sticky, bail out.
Now, I'm trying to bring you in, sir. I'll chart the belly landing.
Look, he's coming down. We're closer than the RAF.
Get him out.
What, and blow him up?
What do you mean?
Listen. Here's the RAF crash wagon. Let's leave it to them.
What about the pilot?
Look, that's the ejector seat. If you muck around with that, it's 10-1 it'll go off. It's charged with explosives.
What?
Look.
Right, come on, Corporal. Right, it's unlocked. Give me your hand. Hold on while I make it safe. Right. Oxygen. Emergency oxygen. RT. Dinghy. Parachute. Give us a hand, will you? Watch his legs. Okay, I've got it.
How is he, Doc? Ooh. He'll be all right. Just knocked out, that's all. Put him in the ambulance.
Well, you chaps certainly didn't waste much time getting here. Smart work. The pilot will be okay. It's a good thing, though, you didn't try and break into that cockpit to try and get him out.
Well, we would have tried, sir, but George here stopped us. He said something about an explosion of the ejection seat.
That's perfectly right. If you'd have set that thing off by accident, you'd have blown yourself sky high, and the pilot as well. It's a pity more people don't know as much about this as you.
Well, I've read a bit about it, sir. And of course, I saw the danger sign. I believe those ejection seats are the only hope of getting a crew out of a jet if it can't be landed safely.
True enough. But the ejection seat can be a lethal weapon if you don't know how to handle it properly. Everyone ought to know how to make it safe.
That's why we made this film. Everyone must know about the ejection seat and how to make it safe. Especially members of the police, the fire service, and civil defense personnel. Any of whom may be first on the scene when an aircraft has crashed. With more and more jet aircraft coming into service, an incident like the one you have just seen may happen anywhere at any time. And if you were the first person on the scene, the life of the men in the seat, and your own life too, may depend on you doing the right thing. Naturally, the question of saving the lives of aircrew is nothing new.
In the early days of flying, when 150 miles an hour was considered fast, bailing out was simple and comparatively safe, provided the pilot kept his head and pulled his ripcord at the right moment. But to attempt to jump out of a modern high-speed jet aircraft is virtually impossible because of the pull of the slipstream. So all these new jets are fitted with a device enabling the aircrew to bail out safely in an emergency.
With this equipment, the pilot is fired out of his disabled aircraft like a shot out of a gun. The seat is a complete unit, sliding on guide rails and fixed to the cockpit at these points. This long tube inside here is the ejection gun and is fired like any normal gun. It's loaded with two cartridges.
The cartridges are fired by pulling this handle, which in turn pulls the cable here, operating the firing mechanism. So when the handle is pulled, the whole seat with the man in it is instantly shot clear of the aircraft, high enough to escape the powerful slipstream.
Once clear, the man has to roll forward out of his seat and open his parachute. So that he can manage to do this easily, the seat has to be stabilized. It is done by a drogue, or small parachute.
This is the drogue gun. Attached to the drogue gun firing mechanism, there is a cable. One end of the cable is fixed to this container, which is part of the aircraft itself. The container holds 24 feet of cable. When the seat is shot upwards, the cable is drawn out and becomes taut, operating the firing mechanism.
A cartridge is exploded in the drogue gun here, and this bullet is shot out. The bullet draws the drogue out of the container. The drogue opens, streams above the head of the seat to stabilize its downward fall, and the man in the seat rolls off quite easily. Of course, the man has to be strapped into the seat, and this is how it's done. First, the parachute harness has to be done up.
The seat straps clip into a quick-release buckle and can be disengaged easily with one hand. The RT plug is a push-in plug, which breaks automatically when the man rolls off the seat. Next, the main oxygen tube. Now, the emergency oxygen tube, which has a spring-loaded positive connection to an emergency oxygen bottle in the dinghy pack here. This tube must remain connected when the pilot leaves the seat. Finally, the dinghy strap, which also must remain connected.
Now all the attachments and safety devices are in order, and he's ready to take off.
But here's the most important thing to remember about the ejection seat. When the safety pin with its round metal label is clipped into the sear of the firing mechanism, here, the mechanism is locked and the ejection gun cannot be fired. Before taking off, the pin is taken out and placed in the marked stowage pocket. Now the firing mechanism is unlocked and the ejection gun is live and ready for an emergency. So, to make the seat safe and avoid accidents on the ground, the pin must be clipped back into the small hole in the sear of the firing mechanism. Now the seat is completely safe.
To prove the safety of the ejection seat in use, many tests were made with dummies. There goes the seat. For these tests, a parachute is attached to the seat itself, so that it may be salvaged and examined. There's the seat parachute opening. You can see the parachute attached to the dummy opening now, just below the seat parachute. These experiments are still going on, with the object of improving the seat still further. The effect of the action on the human body has been thoroughly investigated on test rigs similar to this mobile rig. This equipment is now used to accustom air crews to the seat and to teach the correct drill.
Sit comfortably in the seat, back well in. Keep your elbows well in, knees together. Now, dummy run. Ready, stand by, fire!
For drill purposes, a single cartridge is used. But when the aircraft is flying, the ejection gun is loaded with a full charge, which will propel the seat as much as 60 feet into the air in a second.
Ready, stand by, fire!
In a live ejection, the actual height reached by the seat depends largely on the forward speed of the aircraft, but it is always high enough to ensure that the seat is thrown completely clear of the slipstream.
Ready? Stand by! Fire!
After many tests on ground rigs and a number of dummy ejections, Benny Lynch of the Martin Baker Aircraft Company was the first to attempt a live ejection. The aircraft used for these tests was a Meteor 3, especially adapted with a second cockpit. There he goes, and as the seat begins to fall, he pulls the ripcord of his parachute. This was the first occasion on which a man was fired out of an aircraft, and the test was highly successful. Benny Lynch made this initial drop in 1946, and he's done it many times since. And each time means more valuable information about the operation and safety of the ejection seat.
Well, Benny, how did it go?
Fine. I touched down very gently, just by the edge of the airfield.
Feel safe in the ejection seat?
Safe as houses. Otherwise, I wouldn't be doing it. The only time I feel nervous is when I see inexperienced people playing around with it.
There you are. Straight from the horse's mouth.
It's the job of the servicing personnel to ensure that the ejection seat is in full working order, ready for an emergency in the air, and completely safe when the aircraft is on the ground. They have to be experts. But if ever you are faced with the job of rescuing a man strapped in the ejection seat, all you have to remember is, don't touch the firing handle, and don't pull on the firing cable or any other cables. Just look for the safety pin attached to the round metal label. If it's in the stowage pocket here, the ejection seat is live and therefore dangerous. So take out the pin and clip it through the small hole in the sear at the back here. Now the firing mechanism is locked and the seat is safe.
Well, there you are. Simple, isn't it? When you know how.